Okay. What is the unit of capacitance? The unit of capacitance is in farad. Yeah. This is in farad. Or we apa namanya? Kita biasanya tulis dengan huruf F besar ya. On farad. Oke, are these capacitors in series or parallel? This is in series, ya. Yeah, this is in series. This is in series. This is in series. Yeah. Then question 3. Write down the formula for total capacitance. Yeah. The capacitor in circuit above. Okay. I have one formula. This is actually same thing with resistor. Yeah. But in opposite. In opposite meaning. Visit it. This one. In the series. Yeah. This is same thing in parallel on the. On the resistor, 1 over C series yeah, equals to 1 over C1 plus 1 over C2. Yeah. Because this is only 2, so until 2 ya. Yeah, if more than 1, if more than that, ya yeah, kita lanjut terus ya. Yeah. Oke, okay. 1 over C series equals to 1 over C1. Oh, sorry. This is only formula ya. Yeah? Only formula. Not find the equivalent R. Yeah? Yeah. Only like this ya. Yeah? Okay. Only the formula. Okay. Then continue. Yeah, in the circuit above, if C1 equals to 20 microfarad, this is micro, yeah. We call as micro. Tulisannya micro, micro, yeah. Micro, micro, yeah. Microfarad is 1 divided with 1 million, yeah. 1 dibagi sejuta, yeah. Divided by 1 million. Or in power is 10 power minus 6. Yeah. So, but we still type this still in microfarad, yeah. Okay, let me check how to solve this question. Like this one, 1 over C series equals to 1 over C1, 1 over C2, and then 1 over C series equals to 1 divided by yes, this is 20, yeah, plus this is 30. Okay, same thing with parallel in resistor, yeah. 1 divided C series equals to we need to find the apa divide apa pembagi ini ya, between 20 and 30 ini kan ada ketemunya di 60. Ya. Yeah. So when 1 over 20 this is same thing with 3 over 60. Yeah. And plus this is same thing with 2 over 60. Okay, so it means 1 divided by C series equals to this is 3 plus 2 equals to 5. Yeah. 5 divided by 60. And after this, we flip it because this is still 1 over C series. Yeah. So we flip it. Yeah. Cs equals to. Yeah. This is same thing with 60 divided by 5. Yes. This is around yeah, 12 microfarad. Now, I put U. Yeah. This is actually not U, but mu. Yeah. They have like apa line before then. 12 microfarad. So combined capacitance is 12 microfarad.
Nggak diubah, Pak, ke nggak di-convert ke farad.
No, no need, no need. Biasanya kalau atasnya microfarad, bawahnya microfarad. Karena this is so apa apa agak ribet jadi panjang gitu. Nanti 12 times 10 power minus 6 sih gitu ya. Ya, rata-rata only in microfarad ya gitu. Cenderung lihat yang atasnya. Kalau dia micro ya ini ngikutin micro gitu. Okay, now this is about parallel. Ah, this parallel, yeah. So here, yeah, write down the formula for total capacitance of capacitors. Okay, the formula is same thing in series on the resistor. Yeah, only dijumlahkan aja. Cp equals to C1 plus yeah, C2. Yeah, because this is only two, yeah, until two, yeah, yeah. If this is more than two, yeah, more than two. Okay, this is only apa namanya sum of ya, yeah, penjumlahan saja. Okay, jadi different with resistor, yeah, but like opposite different, opposite different, yeah. From for the series in resistor equals for the parallel capacitor. For the parallel resistor equals to for the series in capacitor, yeah, opposite. This is what I want to apa give you ya yeah, about this formula ya. Yeah. Hari ini yang ingin Bapak sampaikan kalian about formula this formula. C on the series and C equivalent on the parallel. So I'll move to number six ya. Yeah. Okay, but if you want to stop, just ask me to stop it. Number six, yeah. So in this circuit above or capacitor series or parallel. Oh, yeah, this is series, series parallel, yeah. Parallel. This is we call as parallel. Yeah. Then I go move to number seven. In this circuit above, if C1 is 20 microfarad and C2 is 30 microfarad, calculate the combined capacitance. Ah, ya dari sini saja kita jumlahkan ya. C parallel C1 is 20 and C2 is 30. So it means C parallel means 50 ya, 50. Microfarad. This is actually not U, yeah, but like this one. This we call it as mu. Actually, if you spelling this, this is U, yeah, U, yeah. U F, U F. The spelling is mu. Okay, I go to number eight. Yeah. If the potential difference across a capacitor is doubled, what happened to the charge stored in the capacitor? Okay, now I think it's back into formula Q equals to CV. When you still remember, yeah, we have a formula Q equals to C times V. So we see this, yeah. If the potential difference is V, yeah, across capacitor doubled, yeah. What happened charge? What happened charge Q? So the capacitor capacitance is constant, yeah. So when the voltage doubled, yeah, Q it will be doubled also, yeah. Because between Q and V is proportional, yeah. So charge stored in the capacitor also doubled. Yeah. So charge stored in the capacitor also doubled. Doubled, yeah. Yeah. Why? Because Q, yeah, charge is proportional to potential difference. Yeah, that's it. Okay, maybe I will wait around 3 minutes if you want to see this first, yeah. If you want to check it again. Number 9, if the potential difference across capacitor is doubled, what happens to the energy stored in the capacitor? Okay, now this is the other what I will share to you about energy, yeah, energy stored, yeah. The formula is W or half CV square. CV square. This the other formula for today. Energy stored equals to or W equals to a half CV square. This is like same thing with energy, kinetic energy, yeah, a half MV square, yeah. But M is in capacitance, yeah. V, it's different. This is potential difference, yeah, not velocity. W equals to a half CV square. So go to here. The potential difference across capacitors is double. What happened to the energy stored in the capacitor? When the double, this is equals to 2 square, yeah. Jadi 4 kalinya, ya. Yeah. Apa sih namanya? 4, ya. Yeah. Same thing with W2, yeah. This is equals to 2, yeah, times 2 square, yeah, of W1. W1, yeah, because this is V square, yeah, so 2, because since they have doubled, yeah, so it means yeah, doubled, yeah, so we call it as W2 equals to 4 times W1, yeah. So its main energy stored in the capacitor is 4 times, yeah, than before. Okay, that's it. Okay, question 10, in what unit is the charge of capacitor measured? Oh, charge, same thing with before. This is in coulombs, yeah, in coulombs. This is in coulombs. Yeah. And 11, capacitors, direct current, capacitor, low frequency, but what's the capacitor? This is block it, yeah. Blocking. Yeah. They can blocking about direct current, yeah. Because why? Because they as the charge bank, yeah. So direct current equal is same thing with negative or positive charge, and then they can blocking. So capacitor can be also as the filter, yeah, the filter blocking, yeah. This is actually I think some this is for A2, yeah, but it's okay. Capacitor low frequency but not apa ya, capacitor high frequencies. Maybe I will skip this one first. Yeah. You can find by yourself. Try to find this. Or maybe later on Tuesday we will. I will inform you when I already what this answer. Yeah. Okay. C12, when a capacitor is used to pass AC signal from the module another, it's called as the this is filter. What I mentioned, yeah, this is called as the filter. Filter capacitor, yeah. Okay, when a capacitor is used to remove 50 hertz and or ripple from the output, a power supply is called as I forget, this is on the electronic, yeah. I think no need for you or A level 2, yeah, because this is I think about the electronic, yeah. This is also RC. Oh yeah, I think stop until here. I think stop until this one. Yeah, energy, not go to other question. Yeah. Okay, Rene and Ilona. Yeah, that's it.